Some final thoughts now. The stone cold obvious proxy attack on the 45th president of the United States. Lee Harvey Oswald labeled himself a patsy in the hours before he was assassinated by Jack Ruby. Clearly, what Oswald was indicating is that he was being made a scapegoat for the assassination of John F. Kennedy. Oswald was guilty, of course. But there is a new patsy in the criminal justice system right now, and his name is Roger Stone. Roger is a rather colorful political consultant whose work dates back to the Nixon administration. In fact, Roger has a rendering of Richard Nixon tattooed on his back. But what Roger is getting tattooed with right now is a politically punitive, vindictive, and vicious assault on his freedom and liberties. Roger is now a convicted felon. A jury found Roger guilty of making false statements, obstruction, and witness tampering. And now he's facing prison time. However, it's how he got there that is truly problematic. The case against Roger was born of the Mueller investigation into so-called Russian collusion. Of course, Mueller found no evidence of any conspiracy between Russia and Team Trump. Likewise, Mueller found no evidence that Roger worked with the Russians. All that Mueller's prosecutors uncovered was Roger's flamboyant style. And in the end, that was the so-called evidence against Roger, his style. For example, the alleged witness tampering involved a probable joke on behalf of Roger. He threatened a liberal talk show host's dog. Yes, this was so-called evidence of witness tampering, according to the four hand-picked Mueller prosecutors. And Roger may not have been fully truthful with a congressional committee. You know, like Hillary or John Bredin lied to Congress, and countless others over the decades have been less than truthful to congressional panels that have zero prosecutorial power. Well, the case against Roger is a prosecutorial joke that's not funny. It is criminal and is damaging. So why Roger? Why did this rogue of offshoot of the Department of Justice target Roger among all the actual criminals who are committing actual crimes? Well, the answer is obvious. Roger may have Nixon tattooed on his back, but on his face, he might as well have Trump engraved on his forehead. He's a political and criminal scapegoat. In other words, they couldn't get Trump, so they got his confidant, Roger Stone.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube, and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.